Let's take a moment here to summarize the wave properties we've encountered so far. We have angular frequency of a wave, omega, which is 2 pi times its frequency. We also defined the complex propagation constant, gamma, in terms of the line characteristics, and introduced alpha, the attenuation constant, which is equal to the real part of gamma, and beta, the lossless propagation constant, which is equal to the imaginary part of gamma, or 2 pi over lambda. If the line is lossless, beta is also equal to omega times the square root of LC. We have also defined the characteristic impedance Z0, which gives the ratio of forward voltage to forward current along a line, or the negative ratio of backward voltage to backward current. A wave also has a temporal period T, which is the time it takes a specific location in the line to experience an entire cycle of the wave. T is equal to 1 over the frequency. And a wave has a wavelength, lambda, which is the spatial separation between 2 peaks of the wave. We will add 2 additional wave properties here, phase velocity and group velocity. Phase velocity is the velocity of the phase front of the wave. In other words, it's the velocity of a single peak or trough. Phase velocity is given by omega divided by beta. Notice that if the line is lossy, phase velocity depends on frequency. This means that some frequencies travel faster than other frequencies, which is known as dispersion. When a wave packet containing several frequency components travels a long distance on a dispersive line, some frequency components will fall behind while others race ahead, which causes distortion of the signal. However, if the line is lossless, beta is directly proportional to omega, and the frequency dependence cancels out. In this case, the frequencies are not dispersed, and the signal is not distorted. Group velocity, on the other hand, is the velocity of the envelope of the wave. If a signal contains only a single frequency, the group and phase velocities are identical. However, if a signal consists of a narrow band of frequencies, the wave looks more like this, and this envelope moves with the velocity vg, which is given by the partial derivative of omega with respect to beta.